Why does the West End matter, and what makes the Olivier such an important celebration?
The West End only matters if it's putting on content that matters. At the moment, I'm in a theatre that I think is putting content on that matters. So for me, my part of the West End right now matters. It's got to be entertaining. It doesn't always have to be politically relevant. It doesn't have to do all those things. But it, as a whole, the West End has to satisfy all those demands throughout different parts of it, you know what I mean? And I think it's doing that really well at the moment. The thing that I don't know if it's doing it, it probably is doing it, but I always think like any business, like any product, you've always got to keep reaching out to the new people that are going to be buying your product, to speak like a businessman for a second. And I just hope that theatre is doing that and really properly reaching out to younger people. Not just because the youth are tomorrow and all that, which you always hear. I'm not one of those people that go on about the youth all the time. But the you know, audiences will dry up and they'll just flock to movies if we don't. But I think, you know, I'm not scathing. I think theatre may be doing that, so it's good.
How satisfying is it, not only for you to be nominated, but to be nominated for a piece like The Ruling Class that, like you say, tackles such interesting issues?
Yeah, and also it's just dead funny. This is the most important thing to me. It is dead important. It's also, it was a huge risk doing The Ruling Class. It's not been put on since 1968 for a reason. It's one of the most difficult things to put on, I think, you could ever imagine. And I've got so much admiration for Jamie Lloyd for not just having the guts and the cojones to put it on, but to actually pull it off with such aplomb and bravura. He's a special director, and he's as much tied into everything I've done in theatre as anything else. So it is, just to do something that risky on Whitehall, in the West End, in commercial theatre, not in subsidised theatre, and get away with it. I've got so much respect and admiration for him, and he is what I think the future of theatre needs, you know, and what I think it's getting actually as well. Lots of people like him who take big, bold risks in places that are potentially and perceived anyway as being safe, like the West End. Not being safe in those environments is, I think, what tomorrow's audience want. They want something that is risky and edgy.
I mean, obviously, you're such an eclectic performer, working a lot of different medium. What's the one thing, the essence, that you're always looking for when you look at a project?
Risk, really. I'm always looking for something that's going to stretch me as a performer and a storyteller and teach me something. You learn whatever you are, but you'll learn more on certain things. And the riskier the project, the harder it's going to be, the harder it is, the more you're going to have to pull out the bag to pull it off and do some pretty heavy lifting. So, yeah, I'm always looking to do some heavy lifting, really.
Talking about learning things, we've just had our confirmation of some of the wonderful young people you're going to be working alongside for X-Men Apocalypse, people like Sophie Turner. And are you excited about the prospect of working with young talents like that?
Yeah, no, totally. Stealing all my lines and all that. It's great. More people to take up camera time. I'm loving it. No, she's great, actually. We met at the Empire Awards a year ago, and she was lovely, actually. And also a big fan of her work on the telly, too. So, no, we've got some nice people coming in. We've got an amazing group and a really tight group of people in X-Men, which is part of the strength that I think it translates onto camera and onto screen. So we're really lucky in that. So these guys coming in will be welcomed in wholeheartedly. And if they're naughty, they'll be getting it in the neck.
Hi, I'm Katie Braben, and I've been nominated for Best Actress in a Musical for Beautiful.
How does it feel to officially be an Olivier Award nominee now?
It's very surreal, very, very surreal. I can't quite believe this is my life. I'm over the moon, absolutely over the moon, and I can't really believe it, to be honest with you. Yeah, I'm in shock.
For anyone who hasn't been lucky enough to see Beautiful yet, can you just tell us a bit about what it's about, the real-life musical icon that inspired it?
Well, it's about Carol King and her life from 16 to 29. She goes through a lot of things in her life, heartache, and it's basically her journey from writing music for other people to becoming a star in her own right and writing for herself and becoming a singer, singing her own songs. And also there's Barry Mann and Cynthia Weil, who have also been my friends, who have been nominated for awards today, which I'm really thrilled about. And they are, and it's their story as well, and their music. So it's a great combination of songs, really, because you've got Barry and Cynthia's songs, and you've got Carol and Jerry's songs, which are, it's a great combination. It's fun. It's really good fun. You know, for me, one of the major things is backstage life, you know, really great camaraderie and everyone that works on Beautiful, stage management, people working at theatre, costume, wardrobe, and all the cast, great fun to work with. And it's really, it's just a joy to go into work every day, it really is.
On the press night, you got to meet Carole King herself. How much of a special moment was that for you? Can you just describe how you felt when you did that?
I was in shock because I told people I don't want to know that when she's in because I couldn't do the show. You know, it's very difficult to play the person who's in the audience. So I didn't want to know she was in, so I had no idea. So when she came out on stage, I was absolutely blown away at the end. It was wonderful to meet her. She's so lovely, so down to earth, and such a legend and a genius and someone I've looked up to for a long time. So it was amazing to meet her.
How special is it to have new musicals like Memphis and Beautiful being so heavily celebrated at this year's Olivier's?
Oh, it's fantastic. We've got such an amazing array of shows at the moment on in the theatre, in the West End, you know. Really, really great theatre going on. And that it's such a positive thing. I mean, I just urge everyone to see as much theatre as they can at the moment. I think it's great. I haven't actually seen Memphis yet, but it's on my list. It's on my list.
I'm Lorna Want, and I've been nominated for Best Actress in a Supporting Role in a Musical.
How does it feel to be an Olivier Award nominee officially?
It's very overwhelming, something that I could only dream of. It's just a pleasure to play this part in this wonderful show. So to be nominated for an Olivier is like a dream, really. I couldn't have imagined it. I'm so honoured to be nominated with all of these people as well. And so proud of our show, of Beautiful. So thrilled to be here today. Beautiful is the story of Carole King, her rise to stardom, and we start when she's 16 years old. So you see her story about how she wrote all of her songs, her marriage and partnership with Jerry Goffin, and their good friends Barry Mann and Cynthia Weil, who I play in the piece.
What was it about the production that excited you?
I think the music in the production is a big thing. Carole King songs, I mean, you know, we get to perform these songs, and Cynthia Weil and Barry Mann songs, they're just incredible. But the story has so much truth and so much heart, and it's an honour to play these iconic people every night.
And how exciting do you think it is to see new shows like Beautiful and Memphis doing so well at this year's Olivier?
Oh, I'm so thrilled for new musicals. I think I'm a big musical theatre fan. I love going to see shows. And I think just for all of these new pieces to be noted and to be recognised and to have success, I think is so important. And I'm so proud of all the shows today. I've got lots of friends in all of the different shows. And so I'm thrilled for everybody.
And it's a big question, but what's the magic of the West End? What makes it such a special place to work and enjoy live theatre?
What's the magic of the West End? For me, it's the work. I think, you know, getting to play somebody every night and seeing that audience reaction of people who might be the first time they've come to the theatre and just to see their face, you know, when they watch this show. I think it's an honour to give that entertainment to somebody, and I think it shouldn't be taken for granted. I'm a big believer in that.
I'm John Dalglish. I play Ray Davies in Sunny Afternoon.
How does it feel, the show nominated in so many categories and you personally nominated as well?
Yeah, it's amazing. It's really overwhelming. I'm really happy for the show. We've all put in like a ridiculous amount of hard work. The guy that plays my brother, Dave Davies, George Maguire, has also been nominated for Best Supporting, so I'm over the moon. Like, Best New Musical, Sound, us two, and I think another one as well. I can't even remember what the other one is. Yeah, it's amazing. It's not sunk in.
And for people who haven't been lucky enough to see the show, can you just tell us a little bit about what it's about and why you think it's proved such a big hit with fans?
Sure. It's kind of the backstory of the Kinks, their rise to fame, the kind of rise and fall and then rise again to fame, being banned from America. And it's a really great kind of fun 60s vibrant experience with all live music played. It's kind of like a cross between a gig and like a backstage tour. You know, it's like a half documentary, half full rock concert. Yeah.
Of course, Ray Davies is very heavily involved in the production. What was it like working with him and then playing him on stage yourself?
Amazing. My first experience on this job, we started workshopping it about 2.5 years ago. And on my first day, I walked into a room and it was Joe Penhall, the writer, and Ray. And in that afternoon, Ray sat at the piano and taught us the backing to Waterloo Sunset, which is one of the most surreal and amazing experiences ever. And Ray's been so supportive of what I've done with the show and, you know, taken a lot of pressure off me in a lot of places and yeah, he's been great. He's been great. And of course, he's been nominated as well for musical contribution or something like that. I can't remember the name of the award, but yeah.
What's the magic of the West End, and why is it so important to celebrate it as we do with the Oliviers?
Well, I think it's this, it's something that we should be really proud of, I think. I mean, people come from all over the world to experience a show on the West End, and then from around the country, you know, nationally we should be proud of it as well, you know. Yeah, I mean, it's probably it's the source of the most vibrant and exciting new theatre in the country, so I mean, yeah, we should be very proud of it, yeah.
And my final question, if people want to come and catch the future award-winning Sunny Afternoon, where can they go for tickets and that kind of stuff? Where are you on?
We're on at the Harold Pinter Theatre until October, I think we're booking till at the moment. And you can get tickets at any reputable ticket-selling office. Yeah.
The West End is just a wonderful place, full of creation, and I think, like, for people, it's a place where they can go and forget about their troubles, be entertained and transported to another world. And also it becomes like a community, because basically we have a lot of great fans at Jersey Boys who come back again and again, and we become friends, you know, and like almost we see each other all the time, and I just think it's a lovely community. So I think it needs to be celebrated, because people do dedicate their lives to do their performances 8 shows a week, and it's not an easy task, and I think everyone deserves acknowledgement for how hard they work in this industry.
Lots of people grew up with the music. Everybody knows Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons. They come to see the show because, you know, maybe they've heard that that's the music they grew up with, or that's the music that somebody's suggested, and it's that's an amazing thing in itself. And then they come through the door and see the show and fall in love with these characters that the story is so wrapped around, and I think that's what brings them back, is when they realise that actually it's the story is great as well as the music. That it was a roller coaster ride for those guys getting through that time and place where they grew up, and our story just sort of gives them a little insight into their world, and I think that's quite attractive to the guys who come and see us.
Is there one particular song that really resonates with you when you're performing it, that really speaks to you?
Yeah, I think, well, it's hard to actually pick one because I love so many of them, but, you know, I think the one that stands out the most has to be Can't Take My Eyes Off of You, and it's just such a momentous moment in the show. The show leads up to that moment, and I just think it's one of those moments where Frankie becomes a star, and me as an actor, I get to feel like I'm becoming that star for the night. You know, it's a wonderful experience to feel that, and I think the lyrics are so wonderful to speak of love, and you know, I just think they're very poignant. So I think it's a wonderful moment in the show. I think I also really enjoy the songs like Stay, that kind of happen in the moment of the story as well, so they really resonate with the emotion that we're feeling as well. So it's I think there's too many to pick one, but if I had to, it'd be Can't Take.
I don't know if it's a selfish thing or maybe if I'm biased or not, but it's one of the ones that I sing is Oh What a Night, and it's a classic, everybody knows it, and it's really wonderful to be up there singing a song that everyone's so into. You know, the audience are often singing along with us and clapping along and you know, having a really great time. So for that, it's a special moment for me, because it's like that link between us and the audience, and they really get it. So it's
I agree with you on that one, because they literally get a gasp of air. You know, every time I leave the stage just before this happens and the music starts, and I hear the gasp of air from the audience for that moment, and I think it kind of describes the show very well as well. I think it is Oh What a Night. It is such a wonderful show, and I think performed wonderfully by my acting friend here. So it's amazing. It is an amazing number. Very true, though. I'm just being honest.
Congratulations on your nomination. How does it feel?
Thank you. Thank you. I feel great. I feel numb. I don't know. I'm very grateful. Very, very, very grateful. Happy to be here.
I mean, obviously, Miss Saigon has been rewarded at other award shows and celebrated by fans in a lot of different ways. But what makes the Olivier Awards in particular something special?
Well, the first time I encountered the Olivier Awards was in 1990, during the original run of the show. And our show was nominated, you know, best actor, best actress, best show. I thought it was the most wonderful thing. In the Philippines, I've seen awards ceremonies, and I was actually in an awards ceremony. And, you know, and the name attached to it, the great Olivier. It's a great honor.
And why do you think it is so important to celebrate the West End publicly?
Because that we have a lot of, especially in this country, by watching a lot of shows, there are a lot of great actors, and it's just great to celebrate the achievements of everyone, designers, everyone, actors, backstage, this is the way to do it.
I'm Emma Hatton. I play Elphaba in Wicked.
Hi, I'm Sam Lupton, and I play Bok in Wicked.
Hello, I'm Liza Sadevi. I play Madame Horrible in Wicked.
Why is the West End such a magical place, and why do the Olivier Awards matter so much?
Oh, gosh, I could answer that in so many different ways. I mean, the West End is just, for me, in the world, it's the best place for theatre. We have such a wonderful array of different things, whether it's, you know, the straight plays, the real classical theatre. There's such a conveyor belt of such exciting new stuff coming in, stuff from Broadway, and our long runners like Wicked, you know, that are just phenomenons, and just such a magical place for people to come to escape from everyday life, actually, I think is how I would define it. Mm.
And I'm wandering around this event today with my jaw on the floor. There's so many talented people here. Yeah. People I've watched on stage and gone, oh my gosh, they are absolutely fantastic. And it's, you know, it's nice that the Olivier's happen and that everyone gets a chance to get together once a year and just kind of celebrate it.
And support each other as well. It's a really supportive environment, so that's really good as well. You know, there's lots of friends here. And we're all so excited for the nomination to see who wins. It's great.
It's also very important that because the West End is so chock-a-block, so massive and so full of so much theatre, that people have to decide where to go and which to see because if we win the Olivier Award, that means that it will flag up yet again that it's a really worthwhile show to go to see.
And I think we need to champion theatre as well. I think it's important to get the word of theatre out there. There's so many other distractions. And I think, you know, people need to come to the theatre. So if you've never been to the theatre before, buy a ticket, come see Wicked, and you will not be disappointed. Come to the theatre.
Why do you think Wicked continues to bring people back again and again and again?
I think if I had to say one reason, taking everything else out of the equation, it's the heart. It's the heart of the musical. It has so much heart. It has such a strong theme of acceptance and trust and friendship, I think, which everyone can relate to. And you've got all the bells and whistles. You've got beautiful costumes. You've got beautiful scenery. The songs are just so gorgeous. But at the middle of that, you have got such a huge heart. And I think that's what brings people back, because they can relate to it.
It's a fantastic story, and the characters are beautifully written, and you already know the characters, that's the thing. Yeah. These are familiar characters that you know with a completely different spin.
And then you think you know
who those people are. And then,
that's right, and it's also very nuanced. The two leading, the central characters, that's Glinda and Elphaba, are full of good and full of bad. They're not all good, they're not all bad, and that's quite unusual for women's roles in the musical theatre. They're not usually so interesting, and I think that it's very important for people to see that, particularly young girls to see it. Young boys, everyone really, but it's just quite unusual to see such well-rounded characters, and
I think they're real people, and they are relatable.
And I think that's what brings people back time and time again, is that they can see themselves, elements of themselves in those characters. And it's uplifting and it's inspiring, and that I think is why people come back time and time again, because it is just they leave that theatre with not just I've been to the theatre and had a great night, but actually that it touches them. It really makes them think about things. So We're proud of that. You know, we're proud of what we do as a musical, as well as what we can offer. You know, from an aesthetic as well.
I think the industry, in terms of numbers and audience, is high. From what I've read, I think, you know, ticket sales are up. People are going to the theatre, and that's good. And a young generation is interested in theatre. probably to do with because of shows like Wicked appealing to a younger demographic. I think the big problem with theatre at the minute is the struggle of being part of it, because obviously we're in a bit of a recession and things are very expensive at the minute. And you know, I don't want to get into the argument that has been in the paper a lot recently, because it's not an argument that needs to be had really, but it is very, very difficult for people to really create really interesting theatre at the minute, and that is because of budget cuts and stuff
and
like
we
that.
We need funding, and this industry brings a huge, huge amount of money into the Treasury. Masses, just in VAT alone. So it's a fantastic tourist attraction too. So it's a very, very good, marvellous thing to invest in.
I think the theatre industry earned more for the country last year than the football industry did.
Despite a recession. People come to the theatre when things are bleak for them in other parts of their life. The theatre, live theatre, is something for them to come to and forget, you know, to go away. And so despite a recession, theatre thrived. And that needs to be reflected in the funding. It really does.
It needs support. It needs government
Absolutely.
Support.
In recent years, we've seen such huge success for shows like Les Mis and Jersey Boys being turned into film versions. I guess the obvious question fans have is, when are we going to see a Wicked movie? Because it seems like it would make a perfect transition.
I think it's already in the pipeline. I don't know exact dates or facts, but there are talks.
Been whispers for a long time.
Yes. Yeah. So I don't have any further information on that, I'm afraid, but I do think that it's a natural progression for such a successful show.
It will come.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
One day.